Next, we'd like to take a look at measuring resistance. What I've done here is I've actually taken some time to swap out my traditional test leads for some other options that you might consider investing in for a small amount of money that'll just make your life easier when using the meter. When we go to take bridge resistance measurements of a load cell, we're dealing with several different wires here. And we want to make sure that as we take the measurement, we're not actually touching the probes. Some folks will, you know, pinch the wire up against the probe, and that can give you some bad readings. So we want to make sure that we're not touching the equipment there. So we have these little plungers that have a hook that comes out, and that can very easily grab on. For example, we'll grab this red wire here, and that'll hold on to that wire for me so that I don't have to touch it. And I'll just use the black plunger here to grab on to the black wire. And now I don't have to worry about creating any sort of interference with my own body touching the wires, because our body does have electrical properties as well that can influence the measurement. Another option here are the alligator clips as well that can grab onto things and hold on for you. Now, to take the bridge resistance measurements of the load cell, it's very important that when we take resistance measurements that you don't have any power applied to the system. Unlike voltage, we're not going to measure any voltage unless there's some power there to provide the voltage. But in measuring resistance, we want to make sure there's no power going through. Not only can that mess up your readings, it could potentially damage your meter, so we don't want to do that. So I've got my two connected here, and what I'm going to look for on my meter, on the dial, is I'm going to look for the Greek letter omega. It's sort of a horseshoe shape, and that is the symbol for ohms, which is our unit of measurement for resistance. So I'm going to go ahead and turn my dial to that setting. And we see, again, it's auto-ranging, so it's automatically selecting for me here. And we do have to be careful when we're looking at these. You'll see right at the top here, it says K and then the omega symbol. So K ohms or kilo ohms, kilo meaning thousand. So I have 0.997 kilo ohms, which is 997 ohms. So this is the measurement I'm getting off of the black and the red combination of the bridge. And of course, we've got multiple other connections there that we're going to measure to finish out measuring the entire bridge. But this is how we would go about measuring resistance. Again, make sure you don't have any power applied to the system when you take this measurement. Another example of using a resistance measurement that's really helpful for scale technicians is to perform what we would call a continuity test, where you can essentially use that resistance measurement to verify, you know, which pin and which wire are connected to one another. And so in this example, what I'm going to do is I'm going to use my plunger for the wires. So I might go ahead and connect up to, let's say, the green wire here. So we'll put the plunger on there. That'll hold that for me. And then I have my traditional test lead set up for my other connection. What I'll do is go ahead and set my meter once again to the measurement for resistance. And another thing to make note of is that some voltmeters will also have the ability to generate a tone that will inform you that you have a continuous loop. That's the continuity test. In other words, I've got a complete loop and power would be able to flow through that particular connection. This is a great way not only to test which pin goes to which wire, but it can also be a good test when you know a particular pin goes to a particular wire to test that there isn't some sort of internal damage where that connection has been severed or something of that nature. So I'm going to go ahead and press my button here that's going to allow me to hear the tone. And what I'll do with my traditional probe is I'll go through and I'll just touch each of the pins here. And I know I'm connected to the green one. And where I hear the tone, It's not on number one, not on two, three, four, five, six, seven. Oh, sounds like it's pin 8, belongs to the green wire. And so again, that's a great way to let us know. If I'm looking for a certain couple of pins for my wiring setup, this will let me know without having to wire up all the different combinations, because, well, that would take all day.